Barça, Barça, Barça.
Hello and welcome to the Talk FCB, and welcome back here to the channel, guys. Round 2 of the La Liga season is about to get underway as we head now to newly promoted Real Valladolid. Can we follow up our win in our first game against Alavés? We are going to find out here coming up. Is the match preview. And once again, guys, we will be the final game on that Saturday night, with the game kicking off at 10:15 local time in Spain, which will be another late kickoff for the local fans, and many of us too around the world will have those late kickoff times. And as speaking, here are the times right around the world where you are. Some of the times are very good for you guys, others not so great. So hopefully, guys, you can all enjoy the game, and hopefully we can kick on from that first win and get another one. And now, if we just take a look at your predictions, guys, and thank you as always for getting involved in the voting. And we can see quite clearly here the majority of you are once again expecting a very comfortable win, and a lot of you were right the last time as well with our 3-0 win against Alavés. A lot of you this time siding with either a 3-goal win or even by 4+ goals away at Valladolid. Here's to hoping that it is that comfortable. And in terms of what our rivals are going to be up to this weekend in La Liga, Atletico Madrid will be following up their draw against Valencia in round 1 with a home clash this time round against Rayo Vallecano, which will be actually the match before ours on that Saturday afternoon, and that'll be a game certainly they will expect to go into that and win it for sure. Real Madrid, meanwhile, will once again play on Sunday after us. They won in round 1 at home against Getafe, and this time round they face a trip to Catalonia, where they'll be facing Girona, and will they be aiming to continue that winning start of the season under Lopetegui? And just before we get into the pre-match talk regarding this particular game, let's take a quick look at the La Liga table following those opening round of matches. Sevilla, Levante, ourselves of course, Real Sociedad, Huesca, and Athletic Club Real Madrid as well, making winning starts to the season. Hopefully we can get to the top of that table, get our goal difference right up there as quickly as possible, and hopefully we can stay there for the entire season once again. And in terms of tomorrow's clash against Valladolid, first of all, if we do start with the home team, the newly promoted team, one of the three teams that came up, of course, from the Segunda, and Valladolid actually came up not in the automatic places, but in the playoffs. They came third overall in the division and then came up through the playoffs later on in May. They also kick off their return to La Liga with a pretty decent game in that opening round away at Girona, a 0-0 draw, a very, very credible point that they picked up, and that was a decent start for them back in La Liga. They are a side, though, that in general, certainly looking at last season in their promotion campaign, they do concede goals, they do leak them at times, their defence isn't the most solid part of their team, and certainly going into the game tomorrow, looking at those recent meetings that we've had with Valladolid, we should expect some goals, we should go into that game with confidence, and ultimately, expect to win it. However, having said exactly that, we must remember our particularly last meeting against Valladolid when they were back in La Liga during the 13-14 season, whilst we were under the stewardship of Tata Martino, and it was actually a 1-0 loss away at Valladolid during round 27, which heavily contributed to us eventually losing the title on that final day against Atletico Madrid. It was a really poor performance, it was a bad day at the office for Tata Martino and his players, a 1-0 defeat at Valladolid, but other than that, you know, that was a shock defeat, that was against all the odds. Our results in general against them have been very, very comfortable, very good. We've actually scored 27 goals in total against them in our last 10 meetings alone, that dating back to 2004, so we always score goals, most of the time we win, but we do have to exercise caution even if we're just looking at that last meeting alone. We have to go there, turn up with the right intensity, as we always say in these kind of games. With newly promoted sides, you've got to be a bit cautious because you know their crowd are going to be up for it, they're going to get behind their team, you can't give them any form of encouragement, don't let them gain that bit of confidence, don't let them into the game unnecessarily. We've got to go there, start strongly, assert our dominance as we like to do, and then, no doubt about it, we should be winning this game, we should be winning it comfortably, and hopefully we can do just that. One thing though, looking back really on that first game against Alavés at home, obviously in the end we did win 3-0. It did take some time to assert our dominance and really put away the chances, and I would say one thing that we really do have to do a lot better, not just in this game, but right throughout the season, we have to be more clinical in front of goal. We really, really do, because our performance, you know, against Alavés was decent, it wasn't really bad, it wasn't necessarily very poor overall, but in front of goal, we were wasteful. There's no way around that. We created a lot of of good chances. We were decent in the final third in terms of our build-up, but when we were in front of goal, when it came down to it, we did not take advantage of the chances we created. Ideally, we'll still show that creative edge against Valladolid, we'll still be on the front foot, but hopefully we can score a lot sooner in the game, we can give ourselves a good chance of making it more comfortable, and score more goals. Be more clinical, be better in front of goal, take your chances, and things in the whole season will be much better. And as we did last week, if we now just take a quick look at Ernesto Valverde, what he said in his pre-match press conference. He did face the media early on this afternoon. He spoke about Valladolid, you know, the way they played against Girona. He took a lot of notes from that game. They noticed their counter-attacks. He said they're going to be a very similar opponent to Alavés that we faced last week, and we're going to try and go into the game in exactly the same way. He also spoke at length about Ivan Rakitic. A lot of rumours, of course, about him potentially leaving the club this summer. But Valverde, very firm, very specific on Rakitic. He said he's fundamental to the team. He counts on him very much in terms of his overall plan for the season. He said his numbers are there for everybody to see. We all know the importance of Ivan Rakitic, and I expect without a shadow of a doubt that he will stay at the club this summer. He spoke also about Sergio Roberto. He spoke about him in midfield. He said he's a possibility to play there. He said that he played in midfield a lot during the US tour, but he is a right back. He said that he sees him as a right back. It's a possibility to play in both, but he still sees Sergio Roberto as a possibility to play in that defensive position. And he also spoke, most importantly, I thought it was an interesting quote by Ernesto Valverde today. He was asked again about the Champions League. This seems to be a regular theme from the Spanish media. They do like to quiz him on the Champions League. And he said, basically, I know the importance of winning the title, winning La Liga. The fans obviously want to win the Champions League, and I would like to win it too, but we don't see it as a be-all end-all. He said, we don't really count on winning that every single season. He said he likes to win it. Of course, he wants to. He knows the fans expect that, but he said that everybody at the same time should be happy with the league and with the cup as well. So interesting quotes there from Valverde. He wants to win the Champions League, but he doesn't feel like he should be expected to win it at Barcelona, which I think is not quite on the money. At Barcelona, we all know there's a lot of pressure to win everything. It's as simple as that. It's one of the biggest clubs, if not the biggest club in the world. We've got huge expectations. It's about time now that we challenge once again for the Champions League, and we will all be expecting to do exactly that this season. And if we take a look now at Ernesto Valverde's squad selection for tomorrow's game, reading from the top: Marc-Andre Ter Stegen, Semedo, Piqué, Rakitic, Sergio Busquets, Coutinho, Arthur, Luis Suarez, Messi, Dembele, Malcolm, Longley, Alba, Munir into the squad this week, Sergio Roberto, Arturo Vidal, Samuel Umtiti, and also Echeta, who's the goalkeeper, who's going to come in as our number two for this specific game alone. Cillessen, of course, injured. And you will notice in that squad selection some very interesting absentees, by the way, of Rafinha and also Paco Alcácer, both of which have been linked with moves away from the club throughout the week. Very, very heavily rumoured that Rafinha could go to Betis, Alcácer to Dortmund. A very interesting article from Bild, which has just came out, that said that Paco Alcácer is very close to initial loan deal with Borussia Dortmund, and at the end of that loan deal, they could buy him for between 20 to 25 million euros. And also Rafinha, Quique Setién, the Real Betis coach, did confirm earlier on the interest in signing Rafinha, but as of right now, the two clubs are still negotiating on how to structure that particular deal. Thomas Vermaelen has also been left out due to technical reasons, whereas Denis Suarez, Sampa Alinha, and Jasper Cillessen all missed the match through injury. And if we now move on to my personal squad selection for this game, this personally is a starting lineup that I think Ernesto Valverde will more than likely base his team around. And I think, once again, it's going to be in the shape of a 4-2-3-1, simply because it allows Felipe Coutinho here to play in this sort of role. He can play there, he can contribute going forward, but he can also slot into a midfield position if and when he needs it. It also allows a bit of balance in the team. Messi can drop in and still have somebody more advanced than he is. He can get involved in the build-up, he can play passes left and right, and most importantly, he can also get involved in the final third. We look really, really impressive against Alavés in our first game. And these two, of course, in away games like this, when it could be a little bit tricky, these are the tried and trusted duo of Ernesto Valverde. He loves to count on Rakitic. He loves to count on Busquets. You've got Roberto here, who I think will probably start over Nelson Semedo, simply because of what Ernesto Valverde there said in his press conference, and also the fact that Semedo was taken off pretty much in the second half, you know, right at the beginning against Alavés, which does lead me to think that Roberto will be back in there in the defensive position. I think overall, though, this team would certainly be enough to take apart Real Valladolid. So much attacking quality. We saw that from Coutinho when he came on against Alavés. Dembele certainly looking for his first goal in La Liga this season. The same for Luis Suarez. And like I say, Messi looked absolutely deadly any time he got the ball in the final third against Alavés. And with exactly that in mind, I am going to go in this game, guys, with a prediction of Barcelona 4, Real Valladolid 1. I think we might just concede one here, maybe on the counter-attack, something like that away from home. But I think we've got enough power here, enough firepower in that final third to really put them to bed, get a few goals. Hopefully we're better in front of goal. If we really put away our chances and we create the same that we did against Alavés, we could really be looking at a comfortable game here and a good performance. So leave your predictions down below, guys. Who do you expect to start this game? Would you have any changes or alterations on the shape or the personnel in the team that I've just shown you? And of course, what do you expect the score to be and how do you see this game going tomorrow? Let me know in the comments down below, guys. I will see you soon with some reaction. But until then, as always, Vesca! El Barça!